companies have reported major breaches in the past few weeks, including Garmin, Instacart, and Twitter.
Yeah, and each cyber attack was very different from the other. Each poses a different threat for consumers. So joining us now to talk a little bit more about how you can protect yourself online is Darian Guccione, CEO and co-founder of Keeper Security. Hello to you. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
Okay, let's talk about these cyber attacks because it really seems like COVID-19, the pandemic, has opened the door to a lot of these scams and schemes. Is that what you're noticing?
Yeah, in fact, it's increased almost sixfold just over the past 4 months, mainly around password-related security breaches, noting that greater than 80% of all of the data breaches that we're seeing are a result of weak password security issues.
And how are they getting those passwords? Is it because they're too easy to predict? Is it because they're hacking into, you know, a company's system and stealing those passwords?
Well, many of these are a result of either credential stuffing attacks, password stuffing attacks, or phishing attacks. But the culprit is really the dark web. The dark web contains billions of stolen login credentials, i.e. usernames and passwords, that are used to make these attacks more relevant and more frequent. And so, you know, what people don't realize is that cyber criminals transact on these stolen login credentials for tens of billions of dollars a year. And the unfortunate thing is that more than 60% of the time, people like us use the same login credentials on all of their websites and applications. So if they get one set, they're typically more often than not successful in permeating a more wide-scale data breach.
Yeah, so many of us are guilty of that. Okay, so I want you to explain some of these different things that are happening. So Twitter, they had an issue with social engineering. I have no idea what that means. What is that?
It's really straightforward. So basically, an imposter acting as if they work at Twitter convinces another team member who actually works at Twitter through deception and trickery to turn over login credentials to a system. In this case, it was the system that they use to administer accounts for a few million people. So at the end of the day, you have to be really careful about who you're transacting with, who you're communicating with, to make sure that you're not dealing with a bad actor on the other side of that email.
And there's also been huge opportunity during the pandemic. Here in Illinois, there were so many people who filed for unemployment. And then the vendor that runs the Illinois Department of Employment Security's system gets hacked, and a million people's personal information might be at risk. If you were one of those folks, what do you do?
It's really straightforward. The key is you have to use a random high-strength password for every single website, application, and system that you use. The easiest way to achieve that is by using a password manager. The password manager will create a random high-strength password for you so that you don't have to ever remember passwords again. That's number one. Number two, you always want to set in the security settings of your application or your website, you want to turn something called two-factor authentication on. Two-factor authentication is going to give you this extra layer of security protection in addition to your username and password that's going to help mitigate the risk of a remote data breach.
Yeah. Okay. Darian Guccione, we appreciate your time. Thank you, sir.